a second display for my Windows PC. Now, chances are you stumbled across this video as a result of a YouTube search, and I'm very happy you did. On this channel, we do like to discuss tech, lifestyle, and all sorts of solutions, this being one of them. So if you are a PC user looking to take advantage of what Mac users have been able to do for a couple of years now with the use of Sidecar, you need to look no further. You are in luck. So let's get started. And very recently, I just purchased my very first PC in my adult life. And although I've been really happy with the Microsoft Surface Laptop 4 experience as a whole, this iPad acts as a very crucial and vital piece to my daily use. And it can be very tricky on this cross-platform experience. Fortunately though, I have a solution for you. Now, if you are a returning subscriber, welcome on back. I am not talking about anything new. Yes, I'm referring to the Luna Display dongle. And why again, you might be asking? Well, now the Luna Display dongle is compatible with Windows PC. That's right, any Windows PC. So not necessarily Microsoft Surface or any other type of PC out there. Any. So if you do already have a Luna Display dongle, all you gotta do is go ahead and just update your software and you'll be all set. But for you new, potentially, hopefully new subscribers, we're gonna go ahead and start from scratch. Now, I originally found this solution and was no longer able to pair my M1 machines with one another. I have this older iMac that is no longer worth selling, but still has a pretty decent screen. And of course, I can't get enough screen time, so I'm thrilled that I'm able to put this guy to use. Now, right off the bat, you will need to go ahead and purchase your own Luna Display dongle, and I do have one linked down below for you. And once you do receive it after you make your purchase, all you gotta do is just download the software on your primary PC, as well as your iPad or any other Mac. And yes, you heard that correctly, any other Mac. This will work on your MacBook, iMac, Mac Mini, any Mac. And now, the quality of the latency will depend on the quality of your own Wi-Fi, but there is still a Bluetooth setting if you'd like. And now, if for whatever reason you do want to use your iPad as your main display for your PC, all you got to do is just go right on ahead and just close the lid, and it all transfers directly onto your iPad or, again, your secondary machine, whether it's an iPad, Mac Mini, iMac, whatever it is. And now I will go ahead and leave some of my older videos linked down below. If it is the case, if you are stumbling onto this first time and you are wondering how this is going to work on your other Apple machines, refer to those videos in the product description down below, and those hopefully answer your questions either directly in the video or definitely scope out the comments. There's a lot of comments in those videos and they answer a lot of questions depending on your use case scenario. And speaking of comments, why don't you go right ahead and leave me one down below, and while you're there, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't, and until next time, see ya.